Holle vormen zit toch niet vol? Hi there! The next video is about a box with a threaded lid. A box with a threaded lid. This is a small one, and a threaded lid means I can take the lid off with a screw thread. Here is a thread and a box that has the shape of a sphere in walnut, and this is birch burr with brass inlay. Burr is always very nice to look at. So that's what we are going to make today. And we're going to make it out of a piece of London plane sycamore.
Is she playing that or what?
No. Bo! Ga maar op je mat. Ga maar op je mat. Goed zo. I was in on holidays last summer, last February, in Suriname, and I was kind of devastated to see what happens with the forest over there. It's completely robbed empty. So that makes you think, why do I need this exotic wood? Why do I have to get my wood out of South America and ship it here? Especially if you see this. This is quarter sawn London plane. If you see, you don't need snake wood if you have this, do you? It's really beautiful, especially when the grain runs perpendicular to your cutting edge. So, quarter sawn material, London plane is beautiful. I can make a box out of a piece of wood in two ways, and both ways you see here. This was one piece. This is made in long grain. So, the wood is like this on your lathe. And this is the other one, side grain box. So that means, so the wood is like this on my lathe. The tree was growing like this. So that means that in the lid we get this beautiful pattern because of it is side grain and this is quarter sawn material. Let's find out where the middle is. That'll do. So because this is side grain, I will use my bowl gouge to take the edges off and do most of the work. It's in between centers now, and let's start. The speed of the lathe is somewhere about 1000 RPM. As you see, I'm turning left-handed now. That means I don't have to stand in the fire zone, so to say. I don't have to stand in the way where all the shavings go. I'm almost round. I don't have to be perfectly round, but it's just that I have the corners off so I can make myself a tenon That's enough. Let me flatten this surface for a while. So that's flat, more or less. And then I have a little handy dandy tool for making a perfect tenon. This tool I use especially when making bowls in a serie. I use most of the time three different type of jaws. The number two from one way, three and four. And if I put this over my tailstock and just... And there's my number three, there's my number four jaws. So the next thing to do is... make the foot. So I've made a tenon for the lid. Let me also make a tenon now for the body of the... of the box.
Thank you.
Okay, so I have now the lid of the box and the body of the box, and they're not quite round yet, but I can start hollowing and shaping and making a thread of it on it. Daar ging die weer.
I like it. It's
flat surface. You want me to put a light in there, please?
Yep.
Okay. This is going to be a straight box. No curves, just straight lines. So I have to make a straight inside. Straight line, and it's not a straight line yet. So I have made a little box scraper. It is a scraper, it scrapes on the top end here. And this part is grinded away a little bit, so if it is in a narrow space, it won't rub against the wall.
I understand.
Good. And it's got to be parallel to the bed ways now, and it isn't yet. het is. So there's the bottom of our little box already. No sanding yet, but you can already see how beautiful the wood is. Also important. And now for the thing that I wanted to demonstrate is making a thread on this box. You can of course do a thread with thread chasers. These are little chisels to chase a thread into the wood. This is, by the way, the thread we are going to make on this box. It's 3.5 mil pitch. I can't chase here, at least I can't chase here, because it is side grain wood. I bet Jan Hovens can chase side grain wood, but I can't. That's why I use the Simon Hope jig. And that works really great and really simple. The idea is that this body will be on here. This will be placed in my tool rest and the cutter will be on my spindle. And the rest you will see in a minute. This is where the thread is going to be. And I've made a little recess there for the cutter to run free for a little while. This line has got to be parallel to the bed, because if it's not, if it's running like this, I never can screw on a thread of a lid, of course. So this one we can take it out. And the cutter on the spindle. Now I have to position it perfectly. When is it positioned perfectly? Well, there's a few things to take in mind. The cutter and the wood should turn in opposite directions. So this one goes spins like that, and this one spins like that. So they have to, if it cuts, they have to make opposite directions. Next thing to be aware of is that this spindle should be, I hope you can film this, Lise. This spindle should be parallel to the bed. Gonna start the cutter now on lathe full speed, maximum speed, because that's about 3000 RPM. That's okay, that'll work. And I will slowly turn this one forward and then we cut the thread in there. Then I take it back. Then I make the cut a little bit deeper by rotating this wheel, so the whole piece will move a bit more to the cutter. Anyway, you will see. This was a very light cut. The real cut comes now. Because if I turn the piece back now, the cutter and the box are in opposite directions, which makes a much better cut. So we'll do this a few times and do it slowly, not take too much in one time. And if you want a real sharp edge, of course there's a danger that the wood will break out. You'll have some tear out in the wood. A London Plane Sycamore would normally easily break out.
But
we have a solution for that as well. Just use some super glue. It penetrates the wood and it makes it a much stronger thread. Oh, only on the thread, Ronald. Oh, I hate the smell of super glue.
I feel strange in my hand.
Dries within seconds, but because that's not fast enough for us wood turners, here's a little bit of activator. And then it is instantly dry. So I can make my last cut now. At least I hope it is my last. There we go. Okay, that's it. We'll leave it like that. So we can take Mr. Hope off my lathe. Tool rest back in. And put the lid in the chuck. Now let's do some measuring. The outside of the screw thread here is now 91.5 millimeters. The pitch is 3.5 millimeter, so I will have my hole here, the place where I make the inside screw thread, will be at 88 millimeters. First, let me flatten the surface. There it should be. Measure one more time, because better be safe than sorry. Lise, do you remember what I said, what the inside diameter should be?
Oh my god. 88?
I think so, yeah. Then I have to take a little bit more off. Just a tiny, very shiny little bit. And this also, this line inside also, should be parallel to the bedways. It is perfectly. Last thing to do is make a little recess back there so that the cutter can run free. Not much wood left, but it's enough to make a thread. There's the cutter. Here's Simon. Something wrong with you if you give your threading jig a name. Same procedure again, full speed on the lathe, very light cut. Unloosen the handle, take the chuck three more clicks towards you, lock the handle to get the play out, and I think this will be the last cut, and then it is time to check if it fits. Okay. Nay!
No!
No, I'm almost there, not quite. I have to make one more pass. I'm gonna do that without the CA glue. Now I'll put it on just to be sure. Let's try again. Cool.
Yeah, woo!
That's nice. So, I have a perfect fit. By the way, you see me all the time with two chucks. I leave it on just because I have two chucks. Well, actually I have more. But, you don't have to do this, right? This is, you can easily change your pieces. Mr. Hope can leave the building. Bye-bye. And I can sand and finish now the inside of the lid. Plenty sanding paper. Let me put some abrasive paste on it to finish the sanding. You see that the wood gets more pretty. That looks nice, doesn't it?
Yes.
As we are doing this, let's put some wax on it as well. There's the lid. We go back to the body. Looking at it now, I'd say we make it a little bit thinner because I think the wall is too thick. Sorry for your camera. That's nice. 240 and 320. So both the inside of the lid and the inside of the box itself are finished now, so I can start shaping the outside. Like I said, I just want straight lines. As you see, it fits perfectly. Now it fits perfectly, but you'll see in a few days that there has been a little bit of movement, and there's always a good solution. Here there's a very tiny little groove now. So if it moves just a little bit, you won't see it straight away. Next thing, smoothen the surface of the lid. And make it a little bit, I said all straight lines, but that doesn't count for the lid. Just check for 1 minute how much wood we have left. Oh,
enough.
Good. This is what I wanted to achieve. So let me sand this and finish this for a minute. Look at that. The box is finished now, except that I have to take the bottom off, but we can make it perfect. Now the lid is closed and it doesn't, the grain doesn't run all the way through. But there it is. This beautiful lid has to turn 3/4 of a round more than it does now. Knowing that the pitch is 3.5 millimeters, that means one go is 3.5 millimeters, which means to let the grain run through, I have to take off 3/4 multiply 3.5 millimeters off this edge here. That makes about 2.6 millimeters. That was my dog.
Dreaming.
No, I think she wants to say it's a little bit more than 2.6. And she's right, she's always right. So I have to take off 2.6 millimeters off here and then try again. Very little groove again. That's enough. That's enough. Bit of sanding paste, Yorkshire grit to be precise. So that it all has the same color. So let's take off the bottom. Box is ready, more or less. I just have to take the bottom off, the tenon off. This one can go out. And I want to take the bottom off. So it would be nice if I could create something that leaves me enough room to work on the bottom. The easy way to do is, no, it's not the easiest way, but probably the best way to do it is to take a piece of scrap wood and make a screw thread in there where I can turn this one on, and then I have all the space I want over here to make a beautiful bottom. And I like beautiful bottoms. The size?
88.
Really? Yeah, you're right. Never use your calipers for doing this, of course. Same procedure again. Let's see if it fits. One more pass. So now it fits. It doesn't have to be a beautiful screw thread. It just has to function one time. Simon Hope thread cutter.
That's okay.
Nou, Bo, ga maar op je mat. Ga maar op je mat. Goed zo. Oké, jam chuck is... My temporary chuck is finished. Put my... box in there. And... Let's start taking the bottom off. I have to do this a bit slowly because it's only in a screw thread. Check if the bottom is a little bit concave. Can be more. Good.
180.
No, 240. We only use 240 and 320 now.
Okay, why?
Because it is cut nicely. It's a very good cut, but where's my 320? I have some. $320. Here we go. So that's the finished box. next time if you're looking for a piece of wood, don't buy this exotic wood. At least you don't have to buy. Look at the surface. It's great. Quarter sawn, London plane, sycamore. I don't need snake wood if you see this. And this tree was at the end of the street here. So exotic wood is just normal wood that has traveled a long way. Box finished. Next month we'll do another video. If you have any suggestions about what it should be about, let me know. Write it underneath here or send me an email or whatever. Because I don't have a clue yet. But in a month I have. See you then. Bye.